everybody. But that's the way they manipulate the lives of everybody in the Western world and in Asia, Pacific countries also now. So, well, we've always found that good works are conducted in the sunshine, evil is conducted in the darkness. So that's why they operate in the darkness. The well, I learned from some of you guys who talked to Slovenaskis. I was careful to spell it right. Excuse me. Longtime advisor to the heads of state in Russia back to the Soviet Union days. And he's saying that said in the presence of one of our guys, one of your troopers, who thought, he wandered outside the grounds of the Four Seasons. And he thought he was talking to another Bilderberg. And he said that, yes, we need a world government. There's some problems we have to overcome. We've got to get rid of Iran. Well, that was clearly saying, we have to create a war with Iran.
Yeah. Very interesting. And it was the lads that are here now, and Alan said that, you need to get rid of Iran, and he's like,
Like, confirmed. Like, he wouldn't say it, like, he couldn't come out. No, that was in the interview yesterday.
Yes.
And it just gives you an insight into, like, what they're thinking. Like, yeah, you're right, there does have to be a war for
A lot of these trilateral kids, like the Bilderbergs, inherited great wealth from the manufacturing industry. And so wars are very profitable. You make tanks and jeeps, airplanes, like the Boeing scandal that shot down one of the early Prince Bernard. So wars are profitable. And they don't care about spilling the life's blood of our young men or the heart's blood of our women. They just want to make a buck. Good Lord, they couldn't have any more private luxuries. You could only own fly so many of your private jets, live in so many of your huge houses, but money for the sake of money is the adventure of it. That's what drives all of them. As cruel as it sounds, that's who they are.
And they're very good at it. They've made a lot of money over the years.
Pardon?
They've made a lot of money over the years.
Yes, definitely.
Especially the Rockerfellers out of Ireland. And what they've done.
And the Rothschilds, my first started chasing Bilderberg. I thought Evelyn Nate Rothschild was a girl because his name was Evelyn. But I realized he's a white-haired old man. He's dead now. And they tactically decided there's always a Rothschild at a Bilderberg meeting. They decided tactically nobody named Rothschild should be at Bilderberg meetings anymore. But the Rothschild family is still there. It's just girls marry boys with a different last name, and here's a descendant of Rothschild attending the meeting. So the Rothschild Rockefeller clique is still quite active.
So, and another thing that they might have been discussing on this meeting was the bailouts, how to structure a way to keep that going.
Pardon?
So in Greece, Greece has until like the 25th of May to pay its debts, they need like a structure for all the other countries that are going to follow.
Yes, all this is still unfolding as far as the economic crisis is concerned. But the Greek Prime Minister, when he made his speech, he was kind of resentful. That's why he was so late. Traditionally, when Bilderberg our trilaterals meet, the head of state of the home country is invited to make a welcoming opening address. Didn't get out of here while the big boys go to work. Well, others always accept that gracefully. I'm so honored to be addressing these distinguished gentlemen. But this Prime Minister seemed to be a little bit resentful. He was deliberately 35 minutes late. And then, it was in somebody's newspaper today by one of the anointed reporters who was allowed to attend on condition that his story not be offensive to the trilaterals. Paul Volcker was angry at him for being so late, so he asked some tough questions and fired some which they don't normally do. Normally, the guy makes a speech and they say, "Thank you, Mr. President and Mr. Prime Minister." And out the door he goes. But Volcker kept him around a little bit to torture him. On the other hand, I find it appealing that the Prime Minister resented being told to say something nice to us and get your ass out of here.
So what do you think they discussed at this meeting?
Well, in addition to going to war, for some reason it's also important that the Russians apologize again for World War II. Well, they can apologize too much for the invasion of Poland, but Vladimir Gizmo had just, on the recent anniversary, just a few weeks ago, of the massacre at the Katyn Forest, where he confessed, where he acknowledged the fact that the Soviets, and not the Germans, had systematically massacred 20,000 Polish officers. For more than half a century after World War II, the Soviets said it was the bad old Germans who did it. The Nazis did it, not us. But then as time went by, in fact, I forgot his name. I wish I could remember to call it. There's a Jewish writer, a very proud Jew, who said it was not the Nazis, it was the Soviets. And he cited, interviewed scientists who said, well, the brush and trees that have grown above those long ditches where the bodies fell show that it had to have been after the Nazis had been had pulled out of Poland and when the Soviet Union did occupy Poland. And but still, they denied it for a lot of years. This year, at the anniversary celebration, Vladimir Putin very specifically acknowledged it was the Soviets, Soviet Union, then the Soviet Union did it. The Russians did it. We're the badasses. But for some reason, it's important for to apologize some more to the President Metskovitz. I check the spelling of his name every time, too. Rushed out the next day to apologize again and denounces that generation of Russians for tolerating Stalin's massacre of 6 million people in addition to the Polish army, saying that the Russian people knew what he was doing. They tolerated it. Well, they've always rationalized that we did not know. But for some reason, that grumbling was important to Bilderberg. I don't know why exactly. But then events will, well, perhaps it's to make Russia feel a little bit less guilty if they're asked to help with the invasion of Iran. That's the only thing I can think of at the moment.
Do you think the Russians would help in the invasion of Iran?
Well, they've been opposed. They don't sound like they want to help. At these this last meeting on about Iran, the group of 20 or whatever they call it, how can we get Iran not to make nuclear weapons? How can we get on site inspections and so forth? Russia has seemed quite cool to it, as had China. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, they may change their minds tomorrow.
Yeah. And what about the Polish airplane crashing? Any word on that?
I don't have any knowledge yet.
No knowledge, yeah.
That there was a kind of conspiracy involved. I'm not saying it was not. I just don't have any information on it.
Right.
But then again, things keep, information keeps flowing after the meetings are over. I'm sure I'll be getting calls from sources in, within the Four Seasons as in the weeks ahead.
Good, good.
Like the girl explained to me that the, well, they've always done this, select a few local newspapers to do a polite little story on Tri Lateral's our Bilderberg meeting. Mm-hmm. Reassured by these are fine people. But there's no way I'm going to write a story that they have to approve before it's published.
All right. Gotcha.
So
I may lie to them and say that they can approve it, but then I won't let them approve it.
So we're just trying to bring it back to this weekend and what they were talking about this weekend. What do you think they did? What do you think they talked about?